श्रीमान वेंकटनाथार्य कवितार के केसरी वेदांताचार्य वर्यो में सन्निधत्ताम सदा हृदय नमो नारायण। स्वामी देसिका एंजॉयस कृष्णन्स अनुभवम इन द लास्ट वर्स वर्स नंबर 12 स्वामी प्रेड फॉर द मोस्ट एक्सक्विसिटली ब्यूटिफुल डिवाइन फॉर्म ऑफ Krishna at the end of his life, Mama Antima Prayane, at the journey, final journey, I would like to have your beautiful divine form in front of me. He had requested for. Now, he desired for at one particular time in his life. However, Krishnan could Kannan with his Sundara Rupam, he is now making him see him at all times, under all circumstances, everywhere. What a bhagyam, what a bhagyam. Swami is overwhelmed with his karunyam and Perumal's adoration for Swami Desika. Akilan avalokayami kalan महिलाधीना भुजांतरस्य यूनः अभिलाष पदं व्रजांगनानां अभिलापक्रम धूरमाभिरूप्यं। द 13th वर्स ऑफ गोपाल विंशति। महिलाधीना भुजांतरस्य यूनः द महिला उत्तम स्त्री महालक्ष्मी अधीन फॉर हर द भुजांतरस्य द इन बिटवीन द शोल्डर्स the large tira aramarbadandro adiyenai uyyakkondade aatkondade. So the divine chest of Perumal, it belongs to her. And bhujantarasya yunaha nitya yuva, the one who has just entered into yavanam and is eternally yavanam, youthful, that yuva who is the adhinam of uttamastri, who belongs to Uttamastri Mahalakshmi always, Sriyapati, because of his paratvam. Hrishchate Lakshmishcha Patnyav, Vadivayinin Valamarbinil Valhindra Mangai, Agalahillen Irayumendra Alanmel Mangai Urai Marban. That Sriyapati Sriman Narayanan, Krishnan, Kannan, Vrajanganam Abhilasha Padam, because of his love for Mahalakshmi and is occupying the divine chest occupied by Mahalakshmi, these gopikas also have completely been swooned, have fallen head over heels in love with his divine majestic beauty. So Abhilasha Padam, he is the target of their love, their desire. And these Vrindavana Gopikas, Vraja Angananam, Abhilapakrama Dhuram Abhirupyam, the Saundaryam, Abhilapakrama. So his Saundaryam, his Anga Avayava Saundaryam, every part of his Trimeni, is beyond description, beyond narration, beyond even the ultimate beauty can never be enjoyed as in a wholesome manner, in a holistic manner. And that he is beyond description, ineffable beauty, indescribable beauty, and that matchless, peerless, opparilappan beauty, akilan kalan avalokayami. Avalokayami akilan kalan. Avalokayami means I see him, akilan kalan, under all times, means I see him ever, forever, eternally in front of me. So, Vadivil Kalamellam Udanai Manni, I am seeing him in an uninterrupted passage of time. He wanted to see him just for the final moments in his final journey. But Bikkannan, with his Nirhetuka Kripai, he is enabling Desika to see him at all times in front of him. And thus, he pays his gratitude and say, what a bhagyam, and I'm so grateful to you, I can see you all times. Who is that he sees? Magila Dina Bujantarasya Yunaha. And Trimangayalvar also says, Kavi Bol Vannarvandi and Kannulle Tonrinare in Tirukkurundandaham. Yes, he comes inside my eye. Kavi Bol Vannarvandi. He came in such beautiful Nilotpala Shyamala Varnan. Karumbinai Kandugondain Kanninai Kalikumare. I'm seeing the sweetest, the tasteful, like the sugarcane juice. And my eyes are so beautiful and they are drinking the beauty of that sugarcane juice eyes. So he is seeing him. That Indra Neela Shila Kandampol Shyamala Thirumeni, like the cut sapphire blue gemstone. He is like that. Pratyaksha Samana Karamai Ivar Kanmunne Tondri. Pratyaksham, he is there. He is able to see him physically in front of him. And not just him, with Sriyapati, Mahiladina Bhujantarasya Yunaha, and the Yuva, Nitya Yuva, eternally youthful, Purushottaman, Sriyapati, he is there in front of me. And Mahila Malaral Dhanatullan Neela Tunga Stanagiridati Subda Mubdoptya Krishna, the one who is desirous of residing in the breast of Sri and in the breast of Neela Devi. Now they are also desirous of residing in his divine large strong chest in between the two shoulders. And Gopikas, when Krishna was leaving Gokulam, they were saying that you would be deceived and you would be lured by the tactful, intelligent talks of Nagarastri, the city women, and you would forget us, you would not come back to Gokulam. Gopis complained. Similarly, Sri Bhumi Neela Devi also perhaps says that their Priyan Kannan, once he goes and sees Vedanta Desika, because of his Madhura Pechi, because of his poetic and tactful, intelligent talk, because of his scholarship, because of his intense devotion and adoration for Kanna, he would forget us, the Bhuma Devi and Sri Mahalakshmi think. And hence, they have made his divine chest as the place of residence, say Acharya nicely. And same case when Kuchela was there, appeared in front of Kanna in his palace. Rukmini Devi also performed Kaikaryam sitting next to Krishna, and she was enjoying the conversation between Kannan and Kuchelan. Similarly, Periya Pirati also is there in front when Kannan appeared in front of Desika. Periya Pirati also was there. Mama Hridaye Vartate Savarodaha in Bhagavad Dhyana Sobhanam says. So Periya Pirati also came, says Swami says in Bhagavad Dhyana Sobhanam. So Vrajangananam Abhilashapadam, Kannan Abhirupyam, Kannan's Divya Saundaryam is so beautiful, so majestic, so exquisitely nice vision to behold in our eyes. The Gopikas were completely lustful and desirous of having him. That Abhirupyam, they completely enjoyed him. How much bhagyam they would have had. And they went behind him at all times. Even when Raman was there in Chitrakutam, the hunter women, the hunter the women folk of hunter group, they all fell in love with Rama's Abhirupyam. Pongiya Parkadalul Pallikolvanai Punarvador Ashayinal Yen Kongai Kilarndu Kumaitu Kuduhalitte Aviyai Agulam Seyyum. Andal says in Nachiyar Thirumali, he is there reclining in milky ocean, the Tripparkadal, and to that Emberuman, I would like to unite myself with him, and with that desire, with that love for him, with that devotion for him, and longing him with the pangs of separation, just thinking of him and his divine beauty and his Anga Avayava Saundaryam, my breast swell with happiness, and they would like to embrace the shoulders and the divine chest of Perumal. And that is the way. Now Abhilashapadam, the word Abhilashapadam needs to be enjoyed in that perspective. Then only the inner Thiruvullam of Desika can be understood. That's the reason the Acharya says, we need to explain all these things. And Abhilapakrama Duram, he is beyond comprehension. He is beyond description. He is matchless beauty. He is ineffable beauty. Yato vacho nivartante apra apya manasasaha. Teyeshatam manushya gandharvana mana teyeshatam teyeshatam. How much is the anandam thinking of him? How much is the anandam being with him? How much is the anandam uniting with him? How much is the anandam looking at him and having his divine darshan? There is no way that one can describe. He is vachama gocharam. He is not, we cannot contain him in words. We cannot even contain him in thoughts. We cannot say he is this much beauty or he is this much finite beauty. He is infinite beauty. And this beauty is not going to wear off after a few years. It's there, nitya yuva, atyanta samyoge dvitiya. There is no dvitiyam. Oppar illar, oppar mikkar ilayaya mamayam. He is opparil appan. And daridran, when daridran gets sampath, when a poor man gets sampath, he forgets his past. Similarly, the viraha tapam, the how much we suffered with the pangs of separation, being away from him, is forgotten when we are united with him. And now he is there at all times. He is going to be here forever. So in Namalvar, in Thiruvayamali, Vellai Churishang in Thiruvayamali 7.3 decade, and Thirukurugai Piran Pillan writes in Avatarikai, Alvarukku Purvam Patta Virahamellam Periya Perumaaludaiya Kaada Samslesham Kidaitha Udane Marandu Poyinavam. Kaada Samslesham means he comes and hugs him tightly, Nerikki Kattikondad, hugs him tightly. And when Periya Perumal comes and hugs Nammalvar tightly as the Parankusha Nayaki, and whatever the viraha tapam, the pangs of separation he had before, all has been forgotten now with this Vellai Churishangu Pasuram. Similar way, Abhirupyam Akhilan Kalan Avalokayami, Abhilapakrama Duram, he is beyond comprehension and matchless beauty. And now I am able to see the Saundaryam at all times and in front of me. What a bhagyam, what a bhagyam. And that is what Swami mentions, that Lord came to the Acharya's very close vision along with Sri. And if he is dear to her, he does not cherish a soul, Jivatma, like that of Swami Desika any less. And Desika is no way inferior to Mahalakshmi. Similar way, he is dear to us and then to the lotus bond, Thiruvayamali says. So Desika says in wonder, he is the love personification, love object, love target of Gopikas. And here he comes. The Vedic assertion says the supreme bliss is beyond all mental and oral understanding, comprehension, and which is deemed to cover his Saundaryam as well. The qualities mentioned, the presence of divine consort, the target of love of the Gopikas and the charm of indescribable beauty are all visualized in front of me at all times, says Swami Desikan most beautifully. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari Vedanta Acharya Varyome Sannidattam Sadahrati. On our continuous non-stoppable enjoyment of Kannan Anubhavam, we are now going to enjoy the 14th verse of Gopala Vimshati of Swami Desika on our Kannan Anubhavam series. The 14th verse, Hriti Mugda Shikhanda Mandano Likitakena Mamaisha Silpina Madanathura Vallavangana Vadanambo Jadivakaro Yuva. In the 12th sloka, Swami prayed for the jnanam on Kannan Vishayam. Adaragita Charu Vamsanala Makutalam Bimayura Pinchamala Harinira Silavi Banganila Pratibasantamantima Prayane. He wanted the Kannan Vishayam as the jnanam in the final journey. In the 13th sloka, he asked for Avala and Mahiladina Bujantara Seyunaha Abhilasha Padam Prajangananam Abhilapakrama Duram Abhirupyam Akilana Avalokayami Kalan. Akilan Avalokayami Kalan means in front of his eye for the Purakkan, for physically now Kannan is his Vishayam. Now in this lokam, he says, in the inner eye, in the cavity of his heart, he is now having Kannan as his Vishayam. In the inner, in the inside, Ahakkan. Hriti Mugda Shikhanda Mandano Likitakena Vamaisha Silpina Madanadura Vallavangana Vadanamboja Divakaro Iva. Mugda Shikhanda Mandanaha. He has the beautiful, nice, the blue-colored, multicolored, the peacock feather as the Abharanam. Madana Adura Vallavanga Vallava Angana Vadanamboja Divakara. So the Gopastri, who are being tortured by the Cupid, the goddess, the Lord Manmatha, the god of love. So he sends his karumbu, through his karumbu will, he sends the love arrow to Gopikas and torture them with the pangs of separation and the love desire for Kannan. And because of that, they long to unite with Kannan and they have the viraha tapam. And when Kannan appears, immediately when he appears like the rising sun, and when he sees the beauty, majestic beauty of, when they see the majestic beauty of Kannan, they bloom immediately like the freshly bloomed red lotus flower. Their faces bloom. Their face itself is like the tamarai, the lotus flower, and it blooms vikasam, and it blooms so beautifully and opens up, looking at the divya saundaryam, the beauty and the majestic effulgence Kanna. So vadana amboja divakaran. Divakaran means sun, amboja lotus, vadana mukham, Vallava Angana Gopastri, Adura tortured, Madana Manmatan. So the Gopastri, who are being tortured by Manmatan with his love, with his the love arrows, and they long to unite with Krishna, and they have the viraha tapam, and the effulgent sun Krishna appears. And immediately the lotus flower, their faces bloom. That Yesha, that this Yuva, Nitya Yuva, youthful, the one who is the young, youthful, majestic beauty, Kannan. Kena Shilpina Mamahriti Likitaha. So that Kannan and the Gopikas enjoying him, their beautiful red lotus faces blooming with so much of happiness and bliss and joy looking at him. This form is drawn so beautifully, is sculptured in my heart, in the wall of my heart. It is so nicely sculptured. Which Silpi, which sculptor has made this in my heart, which itself is Sanchalam? It always moves here and there. It is so much of vacillating. It would not be stable for somebody to draw, paint, or portrait, or even make a form on an art. It, because it's not a stable place, it's so Sanchalam. Sanchalam hi mana Krishna, says Arjuna. So, who did that? Kena, which Silpi? Who is that sculptor who drew that in my heart? Swami says. So, Swami is able to visualize Krishna and the Gopika and their enjoyment for each other in the cavity of his heart, as if it is a portrait, as if it is a silpam in his heart. So, somebody has written. Who could have been? Obviously, it is he who himself has written. That's what is implied here. So, which bold artist, which skillful artist, which very nicely has drawn this in such perfection in my vacillating mind, in my Sanchala mind, in my heart, which will not be stable, which will not be balanced. How did he draw this picture of this insatiable nectar, Ara Amudan, known as Gopalan, in my heart? Who has written this? Who has sculpted this personification of beauty, adorning the charming peacock flowers, feathers on his hair, on the curvy black tresses? Which painter has painted this picture of this beautiful, youthful form, Krishna? Looking at him, the Gopika's face bloom like a morning lotus-like faces of that viraha thapam, with that languishing gopis, and looking the lotus flower blooming, looking at the rising morning sun. Who is that? So, some may question here, how Swami Desika could see the Parabrahman whom nobody can comprehend, whom Vedas and Upanishads cannot comprehend. Yato vacho nivartante apra apya manasa saha. When such is the case, how Swami is able to see in real concrete form when the Upanishads are chasing him? Yes, one cannot see in his own effort. But if Krishna Kannan chooses to appear on his own, nobody can stop. Yame vaisha vrnute tena labhyaha tasyaisha atma vrnute tanum swam. The Upanishad declares that he shows his whole form before one. He chooses the one to whom he will show the whole fullest form. Tamaruhanda devurvam avurvam tane. There is no contradiction here in Swami Desikan's statement that Acharya Sarvabhauman is seeing the Lord in his heart and heart's cavity of the heart with his head adorned with lovely peacock feathers and other Sukumara Rupa Lakshanams and the Gopikas enjoying his divine beauty. And who possibly could have painted this? Swami wonders. This is equivalent to the Sankalpa Suryodayam, where Swami also in that slokam, he says, Mayas Tvashtanyo Va Vipula Mahima Vishwasrugapi Shvashak pratyayam chittam chitram kimayina vidhatum kritamukaha akanda brahmanda pratamatara shilpi sa bhagavan swayam padma ja nirvyalikitaya shilpam swavishayam. Here he says vyalikadiha chitram swavishayam. He himself must have drawn this. Kena vikitaha kam brahma kam brahma. And the sukha swarupan, he himself must have written this. He himself must have painted this. And yeko naika savakkakim yatra kani didikaha. Sahasranama Bhashyam also says prakasha on a Bhagavan. He himself has enabled this. Otherwise, it would not be possible. And Sankalpa Suryodayam Shlokam also mirrors the same thing. And we can enjoy the verse of the unparalleled verse of Yadavabhyudayam, the first chapter, the ninth verse. The worth and excellence of this Yadavabhyudayam are extremely high. And it is so eminent that the wonderful commentator Appaya Dikshitar, who wrote 2 centuries later Swami Desikan, and he was completely overwhelmed the majestic beauty of the Kavyam Yadavabhyudayam. And especially he observes after writing the ninth sloka, the commentary, that Krida Dhulikaya Swasmin Kripa Rushi Daya Swayam Yeko Vishwamitam Chitram Vibhusriman Aji Janat. And where this unparalleled ninth sloka, he says from the mai, the paint brush and the paint liquid, the liquid is nothing but the karunyam, and the brush is nothing but his leela, the divine sport. He alone can create this world. The Lakshmipati alone can create this world on his own accord, with his own effort. And Swami says Krida Dhulikaya Kripa Rushitaya. Other than these two, all other letters are Lalita Prayoham. So lucid, simple, tender words. And Swami says Swayam Swasmin Yekaha, Vedanta Desika says. And Appaya Dikshitar is wondered so beautifully that Purushottaman, the one who is declared in Purusha Suktam that Krishchate Lakshmischa Patnyav Sriyapati, is the one who created this Srishti, as if he drew the paint. And Swayam Swasmin Yekaha, the Vishishtadvaita Shintantam, is so beautifully established with Nimitta Karanatvam, Upadana Karanatvam, Sahakari Karanatvam. All these things are so subtly put in this verse nicely. And this Emberuman Sriyapati, he is the one who has made this. Purushottame eva Sriyapatitva Prasiddhi is Appaya Dikshita's Vakyam. And he also says, after seeing the slokams and the Visheshartams, Kavitarkika Simmam, Sri Desikan's Kavya Vakyam is there in every word, every verse. The Visheshartams are impregnated, are enshrined in these verses. Ittam vichintya sarvatra bhava santi pade pade kavitarkika simmasyapi kavyeshu laliteshwapi. And even Abhinava Desika Uttamur Swami mentions about this slokam, anavamam navamam. There is no parallel to this ninth sloka where the Lord paints this universe with his karunyam as the paint and the leela as the brush. He himself as the painter created this beautiful, divine, majestic universe from himself on his own with sarira atma bhavam, sarira sariri bhavam. And on similar lines here, he himself on his own with his karunyam has painted inside Swami Desika's heart this most majestic form. What a majestic verse. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha.
Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari Vedanta Acharvaryome Sannidattam Sadahrdi. We are continuing to enjoy Kannan Anubhavam and contemplate on the most effulgent form, the divine effulgence, the Divya Tejas, the personification of Saulabhyam and Sausilyam, and the Purna Avataram, Krishna Avataram. And that's what we are enjoying through the Kutti Kannan Anubhavam or the Yuva Kannan Anubhavam, through Swami Desikan's wonderful Sri Sukti, great 20 verses called Gopala Vimshati. We have covered so far 14 verses. Now we'll enjoy the 15th. So in the last verse, Swami asked for Madanadura Vallavanga Vadanamboja Divakaro Yuva. He said, Hriti Mukta Sikanda Mandano Likita Kena Mahesh Silpina Madanadura Vallavangana Vadanamboja Divakaro Yuva. Whoever that artist, he has painted in the cavity of my heart, and this wonderful youth Yuva, he is there in the cavity of my heart as a portrait. Who has painted that? And now that sampurna chitram is drawn in my heart wall, which is sanchalam. That Mahopakaram overwhelms Swami Desikan, and he performs his Bhagavad Anubhava Preeti, that joy, that bliss that arising out of this Mahopakaram from Pirmal. Swami Desikan is overwhelmed and he performs his Anjali to that Jyoti, to that Mahas. That's the slokam. Mahase Mahitaya Maulina Vinatenanjali Manjanadvishe Vinatenanjalim Anjanadvishe Kalayami Vimukta Vallavi Valayabhashita Manjuvenave. So here Swami Desikan offers his Anjali to Mahase Mahitaya Maulina. Mahase means Jyoti Swarupi. He is the Jyoti. Mahase, he is the Jyoti, and he is the Jyoti Rupam, Param Jyoti, and Mahitaya, he is worshipped, prostrated at Twishe, Kanti, he has got that effulgence, divine effulgence. And who is that? Vimukta Vallavi Valayabhashita Manjuvenave. He is Vimukta Vallavi, the most beautiful, prettiest Gopikas, and Valaya Abhashita Manju Venave. These Gopikas, most beautiful Gopikas, pretty Gopikas, they have bangles in their soft, tender limbs, the wrists, in their hands. And when they are with Krishna, they are so happy, they move their hands and talk and sing, all that. So because of that, their bangles make sound. And when they make sound with maybe some talam, this Manohara flute, Manju Venave, this Manohara, beautiful, sweetest flute is in tandem, in sync with those bangle sounds. So the twinkling bangles are in sync with the sweetest Venuganam. Anjana Dvishe, this Mai, he is like the, he has got the effulgence, he has got the Kanti like the Collyrium, the Kajal, the Mai. So the dark colored Kanti, the dark effulgence, and that is he, Anjana Dvishaya. For him, Kalayami Anjalim, and I performed with folded hands the Anjali. Vinatena Maulina, I bow down my hands. Paniudan Talaivanangi, I bow down my head and perform Karanjali and Kalayami, I perform. So, Swami, in line with Namalvas, Marappara Ennulle Mannina Antannai, he says, Namalvas says in 1.10.10, Marappara, I will never forget, he is there with facilitating me not to forget him, he stays in my heart. That Mahopakaram was overwhelming Namalvar and he became Preeter. For that Preeti, he performs Anjali Pranamam. Similarly, Vedanta Desika performs his Anjali Pranamam now because he was there. Krishna had drawn himself in the heart wall, the cavity of his heart, and Swinanguli Vinivesho Reka Pranteshu Drishyate Malinaha. So the way how he has so beautifully drawn without any damage, without any smudging, without any smearing, especially when the sanchalam, when the fickle mind, when the heart, if it is a stationary wall, you can draw inside the heart sampurnam chitram. So he pays his preeti because of that. And that is what is talked about. And similarly, now Mahase Mahitaya Maulina, he is so overwhelmed that he is worshipped. That Tejas is worshipped. Because when the king is happy, that's the time everybody goes and seeks alms from the king. When the father is happy, then only the children will come and seek something to buy a toy or to get some games, all that. Similarly, when Krishna is happy, when the Tejas, Paranjyoti, Parabrahmam is happy in the cavity of Desika's heart, that's the time the Brahmadi Devas grab that opportunity and come and praise. கண்ணபிரானை தொழுவார் ஒற்றை பிரையணிந்தானும் நான்முகனும் இந்திரனும் மற்ற அமரரும் எல்லாம் வந்து என் உச்சியுள்ளானே. திருவாய்மொழி 1.9.10. And here he says, ஒற்றை பிரையணிந்தானும் நான்முகனும் இந்திரனும், ருத்ரன், சதுர்முக பிரம்மா, தேவேந்திரன், ஆல் அதர் தேவாஸ் ஹாவ் கம் அண்ட் ஆஸ்க் இன் மை ஹெட், இன் மை ஹார்ட், பிகாஸ் they all come and as because of the antapura nyayam, they all come grabbing this opportunity at this time. Anjana dvishe, his kanti, his effulgence, he is like a collyrium, dark collyrium, and he is not like suryan, which is scorching, which is hot, which gives us tapam. Whereas when you look at Krishna, he is so cool. He brings bliss the moment you look at him. Subhashraya Tirimeni, that Kanchi, Snigdam, Sukham, Shyamalam, Ruchi, Vimukta Valaya Abhashita Manju Venave. When that cool, dark hued, blissful form, which is Anjana Dvishe. Now, Vimukta Valaya Abhashita Manju Venave. These gopis are so beautiful. Raghavorhati Vaidehi Shrutva Gunan Bhuvanasundara. This Bhuvanasundara Krishna Saundaryam. Similarly, Raghavan and Vaidehi are so matching and compatible. Similarly, Kannan and Gopikas are so compatible in their beauty, matching. And for his Saundaryam, they completely are matched. And their bangles perform this, make this sound, and in tandem, in sync, Krishna's flute is also making that divine music. So karatalam and Venuganam or Karatalam is for the Karatalam and Venuganam is Paramashravyam, and to look at the divine feast, Krishna and Gopikas are together, and that is what Vedanta Desika is seeing in the cavity of his heart, and so he is overwhelmed with that, and hence Vinatena, he bows down his head, and because of the Mahopakaram, he with Vinayam, he bows down with Sashtanga Pranamam. Like he performs Shashtanga Pranamam, he bows down. Maulina, along with Siras, he also folds his hand and performs his Kara Anjali. Kalayami, I perform. That is what he says. So, to the great effulgence, which is highly cherished by Brahma, by Devendra, by Rudra, and he is the Anjanam, he is a dark-hued, most beautiful form, and he plays the divine music in tandem with the jingles and the bangles of this beautiful, prettiest, beautiful Gopala. They mad after fallen in love with Gopala, these gopis, and perhaps one can visualize a communion or a connection or a communication between the jingle of the bangles and the divine flute music. So it looks like there is a talking between the two sounds, or it could be the contest between the two sounds, like the Thani Avardhanam, between the Mridangam and the Ghatam. It could be like a respectful conversation between the two. So Swami is overwhelmed and he says, I bow down with my folded hands, with a respectful anjali and a bowed head, because of the Divya Tejas, the Jyoti. And this is indeed beautiful conceptualization of the bliss that he gets. People, that there is a difference of opinion, thought here, that Swami performs his gratitude for the Mahopakaram. We can, and Acharya says, we cannot deem this as pranama purvaka anjali, as the pratyupakaram. It is because for Perumal's Mahopakaram, just like Acharya's Mahopakaram, there is no way that one can pay thanks, or one can feel grateful. Potri uraipadum pundiyil kolvadum satrallavo munnam petradarke yetri manathu elil velakka irulanaitum maatrinavarke oru kaimaaru mayanum kaanagilla. Potri pugalvadum pundi potri ugappadum pundiyil kolvadum pongu pugal shatri valarpadum satrallavo munnam petradarke. For the learning that we have heard, for the bhagyam that we have been associated with Sadacharya Sambandham and receive his kataksham, the unbounded grace from Acharyan, just praising him, uttering his taniyan, contemplating him, bowing down to, performing manasa, vachika, kayika, kainkariyam to Acharyan, it is an iota of what he had done to us. Swami Desikan says about Acharya Upakaram, and such is the case, what about Perumal's infinite, uncountable Upakaram to us? No match. And that is why he says, Anjali with the bliss, happiness, Anandam. And that is why I perform Anjali. That we also perform Anjali for the Mahopakaram of Krishna, Mahamahopakaram of Swami Desika. Anjali, Hare Krishna. Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Hare Krishna.